Hello, this is Jack from No Code MBA, and welcome to this review of Card, which is one of the simplest website builders that I have come across. Now, in this review, we're going to go through the main features of Card, the main selling point of it, who it's for, the difference between the free and the pro plans, and also we'll look at some examples of some really cool websites that have been built using this platform. Now, before we get into it, know that there is a free guide for you if you click the link in the description that's going to go through all the different types of no-code tools that you'll find useful for you and your business. So check that out. Let's start with their tagline, which says simple, free, fully responsive one-page sites for pretty much anything. And I think that sums it up perfectly. It's one of the simplest ones that I've seen. It's free, yes. But obviously, most people will want the pro plan when they look at the features. It's fully responsive, and its uniqueness here is it creates one-page websites. So if you're looking for more complex sites that include various pages, membership areas, etc., blogging as well, then Card might not be for you. But I have seen some more complex sites using the more advanced features using Card as well. So scrolling down here, it says it's simple because you can start with dozens of templates or a blank canvas and make it your own. And you'll see later with the templates, it'll give you a good idea about what kind of sites you can build using Card and who they're trying to target as well with their website builder. Now, it also says that it's responsive, and all website builders are these days. It starts with mobile first. It's going to work on your tablet. It's going to work on computers, etc. And then it says free. Okay, so you can build up three sites per account. Use all of Card's core features for free. But we'll see fairly soon that you probably want the pro plan in most cases. So like I said, there are limitations to Card. You can probably see those already. And if you're looking for something a little bit more complex, then check out the description and we'll leave some reviews of other website builders and some comparisons for you too. All right, let's talk about the features now and the optional of going pro. And you'll see the prices soon, but these are some of the key features that you might want to think about. The first one is a custom domain. So with the free plan, you can have peterdoesplumbing.card.co, but with the pro plan, you can have peterdoesplumbing.com and then use Card to host your website for you. And that's one of the key features of Card, is that it's going to host your website, which means that you don't need to buy separate hosting and then upload the files to that hosting service so that your website can be live. Card is going to take care of that for you. Now, you can also have more sites using the Pro Plan too. And this is for people who have agencies or want to do some freelance work building websites for clients. And then they can host the websites on Card under their one account. Now, it might also be for you as well if you want to build multiple sites or multiple landing pages, depending on what you're doing online. Now, the next one is forms. This means email signups, getting people to get in contact with you, leads. And you can integrate Card with things like ActiveCampaign, ConvertKit, MailChimp, all the different ones that says that it mentions there too. You can also have custom and payment enabled forms as well. Now the next key feature is widgets and embeds. So if you're selling something online or you want to use something like Typeform, which is like a interactive survey contact form, then you'll need the pro plan to be able to embed things on your website and use the different widgets that they have listed here. And the last two, real quickly, Google Analytics to track who's coming to your website, and no branding as well. So take that made with Card little feature that they're going to put on there, you can take that off. Now we'll look at the templates in a second so you can have a good idea what it looks like, but we're just going to look at the pro features one more time and scroll down a little bit. There are different pro features. I won't go into too much here, but better quality images, large image and video sizes, site icons as well. And then down here, this is where you can dig in your own time. It's just going to compare the different plans. So there's Pro Lite, Pro Standard, and Pro Plus. And a lot of what we talked about are on the Pro Lite plan. And then the next one up, we have Forms. So if you do want to use MailChimp and those types of services, meta tags, Google Analytics, etc., then you'll want the Pro Standard. And I think you'll agree that the pricing is pretty reasonable. And it's one of the cheapest ones I've found out there. Pro Standard is $19 a year at time of recording. All right, let's look at some templates now. And I've just done a free trial so I can have a look at the different pro templates as well. So what I like about this is it's going to give you a good idea about who this is for. So there are different tabs at the top where it says profile, landing, form, portfolio, and sectioned. So let's start with profile. And they're just telling you straight up what they use it for. Your personal corner of the World Wide Web. Tell the world a little about what yourself, what you do, and anywhere else that they can find you. So you can think of this as like a little online business card that can then link to different websites and services from there. So you might be on Twitter and YouTube and Facebook, and instead of saying, find me on all these different services and do this and do that, you can have one page that goes through exactly who you are, how people can take action, and where else they can find you. So you can think about this as a great thing for realtors, anyone who works with clients individually, or anyone who has an online profile that they want to promote. And let's just have a quick look at these templates here. We'll just go with a simple one here and do the demo. And this just shows us what this is going to be like. So this is Anne Lewis. She's an astral projectionist. And then you can see the form here, get in touch, which is going to go to your email account, and then the different social icons here. Super simple. It's like an online business card where people can then take action with this. Let's go back to templates again. We'll do one more on this section. This is a pro one. And I guess it's just a little bit more the scrolling photos and just having more of a portfolio feel with it. Now let's go back to the different ones. So that's profile. We've got landing. So this is what they say here is making a product, app, service, or something in between. Use one of these to explain what it is, what it does, and exactly how to get it. So you might have an app or a service, something like that, and it's just like a landing page in order for people to take action on. And having these templates means that it takes all the guesswork about where to put the headline, where to put the picture, what contact form should I use, etc. So we'll just click on one. Let's go on this one and go to demo. And whenever you want to use this, it's just as simple as changing this picture here, changing the headline, making this form integrate with what you want to use. And you can see here, it's a landing page and it's a little bit more involved where it's got different sections throughout. So you can actually go into more detail with what you're doing. And soon we're going to look at a really good example of somebody selling something through Gumroad using one of these landing pages. Now the next one is form. And this is designs built entirely around forms that allow you, that can collect emails, gather customer feedback, and even sell stuff. So here's a good example of a newsletter. So you might be on Twitter and YouTube and Facebook, etc. You don't want to build a complex website. Instead, you want to start an email list, create a simple landing page that like this that allows people to put in their name and details, etc. The next one is portfolio. You think about this as creative people who do art, photography, etc. And it's a way to showcase your photos, arts, and graphics. Let's just have a look at a couple of examples here. This looks like a very simple one where you can just see photos on the screen and then people can then obviously take action at the bottom as well. And then the last one is sectioned. And this is one-page designs that simulate multiple pages using section breaks. So basically, this is where Card is saying, okay, you might need more than just a one-page website. This is how you can do it. And I'll show you an example with this one here, where you click on work, and it takes you to different different page, but it's more like a section rather than a page, and about, etc. This actually allows you to do things like privacy policies, terms and conditions, and just have different pages on your site so that you can put more information on that if you need to include legal information anywhere too. Now, I wanted to show this website as an example of how you can integrate payment services in the kind of landing page style by somebody who has created this cool little tool for Macs. So it goes in your Mac OS bar. It's a cash bar. It shows your Stripe balance. And you can see here that this person has integrated Gumroad onto here. So you need the pro plan for this. And when you click it, it allows you to then use the Gumroad style or the pop-up using Gumroad so people can make purchases straight from your website using Card. And then you can see how this person has used the landing page style Card template in order to get across all the features of benefits of their product. And it's done in quite a simple way, but that's what Card is about. You don't need lots of pages here to make this work. Instead, you can just use the Card template and adapt it to your need. So after going through those templates and that example, I think you'll have a good idea about who Card is for and whether it is right for you. So it can be used for people who just want to have that online presence to create that online business card style website, one-page website. It can be used for artists who want to showcase what they're doing, capturing emails and starting email lists, creating a landing page for a service or a product that you have. And it can be also be used for local businesses too, who just want to keep things simple when it comes to creating their own website. So if you've liked this review, then please give it a thumbs up and leave a comment below. And please share it with a friend who would find it useful. And if you want to learn more about No-Code MBA, then go to the description where we'll have some links to the tool guide that where we go into depth into the different no-code tools and also a link to the premium courses that we currently offer. So take a look in the description. Okay, thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.